We are studying about yoga. In our previous heading, we had understand the meaning of asana, meditation, and classification of asanas. There are three type of classification: meditative asanas, relaxative asanas, cultural or corrective asana. I had tried my best to explain you the meaning and the importance of these three classification of asanas. Now today's lecture or today's class, we are talking about yoga for concentration and relaxed asanas. Yoga for concentration and relaxed yoga for concentration and related asanas, that is Sukhasana, Tadasana, Padmasana and Shashank Asana. These are the following asanas related to concentration of our mind. Let's see what is written in a book, and you can do in your home also. Sit down in Sukhasana, you can sit down in Padmasana and close your eyes and you can do it. Yoga for concentration. As you are studying many subjects, it is very, very important to concentrate and concentrate in a various subject in various levels. Concentration is one power of focus on attention on something. What is concentration? Here the first line explains, concentration is a power of focusing. What we are reading, what we are writing, what we are doing, what we are trying to do, focusing in many directions, attention or something, on something. Something means the work which we are doing. It is an important attribute in our life that enables us to perform well in all that we do. All that we are able to understand this small part of line, that whatever the work we are going to do. Meditative exercise through certain yogic asanas help train mind and bring in relaxative state. When we are calm, relaxed, through this technique we can deal feelings of stress, anxiety and focus well on work at mind. There are many studies that have shown yoga to improve concentration, contribute good mental energy and bring balance of body and mind. It is very important to have a balance between a physical body and a mind, because mind through which we are getting many instructions that are done by our physical body. Some of these asanas help improve concentration and discussed as above, and we are going to discuss just now. Sukhasana. Sukhasana is a combination of two words, Sukh and Asana. Sukh means, in Hindi we know what is Sukh, that is pleasure in English, or Asana, pleasure and happiness, and Asana means posture. Posture can be in a sitting form or in a standing form, but we are here standing about Sukhasana. Sit with legs straight in front of the body, then bend the right leg and place the foot under the left thigh. After that, bend and left leg and place the foot under the right thigh. You can practice at your home also. It is very, very easy. Knees in such a way that palm should be rest on knees. Holding like this, rest on knees, on your knees. And back and straight, close your eyes and relax the whole body. Close your eyes and try to relax the whole body. This is the physical formation of Sukhasana and the procedure, how you can sit and what are the benefits. It is very important to know the benefits of Sukhasana. It is a good meditation posture. It improves concentration, increases glandular function, improves leg strength and flexibility, cures arthritis and knock knees. Arthritis is a disease related to joints and bones. In this, there is a pain and there is a pain in movement of various joints. Later on, it is related to a deficiency of a calcium also. It improves posture, we know, reduces stress and anxiety, facilitates mental physical balance without causing any strain and pain. Without any strain and pain, because this is very easy. Strengthens the back. It helps in making us strong, our backbone also, that is vertebral column. Contradictions. The individual who have the energy should not perform this asana for a long time. We can take precaution also. Those who are suffering from arthritis or having any joint pains should not perform asana for a long duration. They can perform, but not for a very long duration. Tadasana. Tadasana. We had studied about Sukhasana, procedures, benefits and contradictions. Same here for Tadasana. Stand up in a tension position, as we always stand in our family or simply standing in our house. Lift our arm upward. Stretch your hands forward, upward and forward. Raise your heels and come on toes. Also pull up your body upward. After some time, breathe out slowly and come to the previous position. So this is the procedure of Tadasana, and we have to repeat for 20 to 25 times. Benefits. It helps in developing physical and mental balance. It reduces obesity, cures constipation. It is related to our intestine also. Constipation, stomach and intestine. Improve body posture. It cures digestive problem. That's why I am saying to you, it is helpful in digestion or help in curing the constipation. It all elevates sciatica. Sciatica is a problem related to our skeleton system, and it helps in improving sciatica. It is an excellent asana for those who want to enhance their height, improve concentration of mind. These are 9 and 10 points. Helpful contradiction. If you have low blood pressure, you should not participate this asana. Whose individuals who suffer from blood circulation problems, that is blood pressure, blood circulation problems such as 40 volts should not perform this asana. Third is Padmasana, is same just like an Sukhasana. Procedure, sit in a squat position, that means your back should be straight. Lift the foot and in the same way, keep it on a right thigh. The backbone should be straight and erect. Straight and erect. Benefits. What are the benefits of Padmasana? It helps in reducing abdominal fat. Reduce unwanted fat in our stomach area. It helps to relax the body. It helps in reducing blood pressure and muscular tension. Contradictions. Those individuals who suffer from sciatica or a weak or injured knee should not participate in this asana. This asana should not practice until you have good flexibility of your knees, because while stretching up your knees, there will be more pressure in joints. If you are suffering from sciatica, you will feel a pain. That's why it is very important that if you don't have sciatica, you can do it. Otherwise, you can reduce the duration of Padmasana. Here we are having Shashank Asana. Procedure, sit in Vajrasana. Place hands on thigh. Keep the upper body straight and relax while inhaling. Raise the both arms above the head. Keep them straight and shoulder width apart. Bend the arms slightly so that they are fully relaxed and let the elbows rest on the floor. Practice this 3 to 5 times. Those who want to calm anger, this is very important. Those who want to calm anger may increase the duration finally position from 3 to 10 minutes. We are talking about anger also. Benefits. It helps to relieve fatigue and promotes concentration of mind. The spine gets a forward stretch and become flexible more. If we are bending ourselves, the spines will get a time to become flexible. It controls diabetes. It increases the memory power. There are 7 or 8 I had told you, but there are many more. Go through all the points. It will help you to understand Shashank Asana and try to do 5 or 10 minutes at your home. It will help you. Concentration, how we can concentration level can be increased. So there are various asanas and various yoga that we can do it. But last is relaxation technique for improving concentration, yog nidra. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट योग निद्रा. ह्यूमन लाइफ हैव बिकम फास्ट एंड हेस्टिक. एवरी इंडिविजुअल इज ट्राइंग टू एडजस्ट इन द फैक्ट चेंजिंग वर्ल्ड बट ऑल इन वेन. Human beings are facing various mental and psychological problems. A technique for pratyahara not only provides relaxation but to the body and mind also has a number of benefits. Yoga nidra usually referred to a yogic sleep. We have to lie down. It's a systematic method of guided relaxation that has profound effect on the body and mind. Stages of Yoga Nidra. How we can prepare ourselves for Yoga Nidra? Get ready for Yoga Nidra. Lie down on your back on the floor and adopt the pose of Savasana. Feel comfortable in this position. Close your eyes and take a deep breath. That is how we can prepare ourselves. Body rotation. At this stage, awareness is rotated through the different parts of the body in a systematic way. Breath awareness. In this stage, you simply become aware of natural breath without any doing any effort. While running, while taking part in sports and game, suddenly our breathing system or respiratory system increase. But in this, that is normal. Opposite or feeling and sensation at this stage, allow yourself to experience feeling and sensation of your. How you can feel sensation by with the help of your skin. Visualization. This stage includes mental relaxation. It develops self-awareness and relaxes the mind through remove of disturbing materials. And what are disturbing materials? When we think of so many things, we think so many things that imagine also. Return or finishing the practice. This stage is important because you have passed out Yoga Nidra. You can feel discontented and uncomfortable. At this stage, awareness is externalized slowly so that you can aware the external location of your mind. Of your inner body, sound, object and a person. And important is advantage. There are many advantages. Reduce tension and anxiety. Relax the mind. Awakens creativity. Regular practice of Yoga Nidra helps in making a bridge between the unconscious mind. Cure cancer, it is very important. A technique of meditation, Yoga Nidra can be adopted and a therapeutic model in treatment of cancer. Helps healing, it is a practice of Yoga Nidra. Gradually, this conscious imagination activates and self-healing capacity and thereby actual healing takes place in a patient mind. When we are still lying, not thinking many things, it helps in concentration. This kind of healing is a term of pranic healing. When the body is visualized to be a perfect health over and over again. Promotes will power. As you are studying, sometimes we do say and we feel that we are not able to do, we are unable to do math, science, but promotes willpower also. Yog Nidra helps in building up willpower and optimize in individual because showed in a unconscious mind repeatedly. The technique of Yog Nidra has preventive, promotive and curative value. Preventive, it prevents from many diseases. Promote in helping our willpowers, and curative, it cures the various kinds of disease that we are not aware ourselves. So this is the end of the chapter of yoga. Hope you had understand. If you are unable to understand, you can ask question from me and you can practice at your home. I know most of you are practicing, but still practice in your home.